हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर आर पी शॉन, प्रोफेसर हैं डिपार्टमेंट इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड कम्युनिकेशन इंजीनियरिंग एट आई एम एस इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज गाजियाबाद। आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन माई न्यू लेक्चर। टुडे इन माई लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस द अरिथमेटिक इंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ 8051 माइक्रो कंट्रोलर। द अरिथमेटिक इंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ 8051 माइक्रो कंट्रोलर विल परफॉर्म ऑल अरिथमेटिक ऑपरेशन, दैट इज एडिशन, सब्सट्रैक्शन, मल्टीप्लीकेशन, डिविजन, इंक्रीमेंट एंड डिक्रीमेंट ऑपरेशन। The first instruction which comes under this arithmetic instruction group, that is the add instruction. The syntax is add a comma source byte. So whenever this instruction is executed by microcontroller, it will add the source byte with the content of accumulator, and after the execution of the instruction, the result of operation will store into the accumulator, means the destination. The operation which is performed, that the source byte which is added with the content of the accumulator, and the result of operation is stored into the accumulator. So this is the operation performed by the arithmetic instruction, that is add a comma source byte. This instruction add the byte variable indicated to the accumulator. The result is the contained in the accumulator. The result is nothing but the content of the accumulator, means whenever the instruction is executed, the processor or the controller will store the result into the accumulator. All the addressing mode can be used for, that is source and immediate, number, a register, direct address and indirect address. So this is the operation, this is the first instruction of the arithmetic instruction, that is add a comma source byte. The add instruction can be used in this assembly language programming in the following type. So we have the first, that's add a comma rn. So remember that in 8051 microcontroller we have the 8 register, which the registers belongs to the register bank. We have 4 register bank, that is B0, bank 0, bank 1, bank 2, bank 3. Each bank will have the 8 bit register. So the first instruction is add a comma rn. So in place of rn we can use the register, that is R0 to R7. This is the 8 bit register. So the example of this instruction add a comma R0, this instruction will add the byte in register R0 of the selected register bank with the byte in the accumulator, which is 8 bit number. The result is contained in the accumulator, or we can say that the result of operation will store back into the accumulator. The second instruction is add a comma direct. So in place of this direct, we can use the direct address of the memory. So the addressing mode is nothing but the direct addressing mode, because the address of the memory is directly specified with the instruction. So whenever the microcontroller executes this instruction, it will add the content of this memory location whose address is directly specified with the content of accumulator, and result of operation is stored into the accumulator. So this is the meaning of add a comma direct. Next is add a comma at the rate RI. So here this at the rate sign will indicate that this instruction belongs to indirect addressing mode, and in place of RI we can use the register, that is R0 and R1 only of any selected register bank. So the content of the selected the content of the memory location whose address is indirectly specified by register R0, for example, is added with the content of the accumulator, and the result of operation is stored back into the accumulator. So this is the meaning of add a at the rate R0. Next is add a comma hash data. So this pound sign will indicate that this instruction belongs to the immediate addressing mode. So here the immediate data which is specified with the instruction, this is 30H, is nothing but the 8 bit data which is specified with the instruction. So whenever microcontroller execute this instruction, it will add this immediate data with the content of accumulator and store the result into the accumulator. So this is the various form of the arithmetic add instruction. Next is the add C a comma source byte. So here, so this C indicate that the arithmetic addition operation is performed with the help of the carry. So operation is performed, the source byte, the specified source byte is added with the content of accumulator along with the carry, and result of operation is stored back into the accumulator. So this is the operation performed by this instruction add C a comma source byte. This instruction will add the byte variable indicated with the instruction, the carry flag and the content of the accumulator. The result of addition is stored into the accumulator. So whenever the processor or the microcontroller will execute this instruction, it will store the result of operation, which is the addition of the content of accumulator, the source byte and the carry into the destination, which is again the accumulator. All the addressing mode can be used for source and immediate number or register, direct address, indirect address can be the form of this add C A comma source byte instruction. The various form of this add C instruction, so we have the add C A comma R N. So in place of R N, again we use R0 to R7 registers of any selected register bank, and the result of operation is stored back into the accumulator. So here the destination accumulator is nothing but the distillation. So if I am talking about this instruction add C A comma R1, so this instruction will add the content of the register R1 with the content of accumulator along with the carry flag, and the result of operation is stored back into the accumulator. Next is add C A comma direct. So here this 10H is nothing but the direct address of the memory location, which is specified with the instruction. So here at memory location 10H, suppose the data is there, suppose 15H is the data. So this data is added with the content of the accumulator along with the carry flag, and the result of operation is stored back into the accumulator. So this is the various form of the arithmetic instruction, that is add C instruction. Next is add C A comma at the rate RI. So the addressing mode is register indirect, because register R0 and R1 of the selected register bank is used to hold the memory address indirectly. That's why it is the example of indirect register indirect addressing mode. So whenever this instruction is executed by the microcontroller, it will add the content of the memory location whose address is indirectly specified by register R0 with the content of accumulator along with the carry flag, and the result of operation is stored back into the accumulator. Next instruction is add C A comma at the rate hash data. This is the pound sign. So this instruction is the example of immediate addressing mode. So with this instruction, the immediate data, that is 40H, which is the immediate 8-bit data which is specified with the instruction. So whenever microcontroller execute this instruction add C A comma pound sign, that is 40H. So 40H is nothing but the 8-bit data. So this data is added with the content of the accumulator along with the carry flag, and the result of operation is stored back into the accumulator. Next is the subtraction operation. So the instruction which belongs to the subtraction operation is SUB B A comma source byte. So the operation is, this instruction will subtract the content of the accumulator, the source byte along with the carry, and the result of operation store back into the accumulator. So this instruction subtract the indicated byte variable and the carry flag content together from the accumulator. The result is stored into the accumulator. So this subtraction is performed along with the borrow flag. So here the carry flag acts as a borrow flag. So whenever the microcontroller execute this instruction, it will subtract the source byte from the content of accumulator along with the carry flag, and the result of operation is stored back into the accumulator. All the addressing modes can be used as a source and immediate number or register, direct address and indirect address. So this is the instruction which will perform the subtraction operation. So following are the instruction which will perform the subtraction operation. The first instruction is SUB B A comma RN. So here this, in place of RN, we have the register which is R0 to R7. So one thing which is required to remember here, we have the four register bank in this 8051, that is bank 0, bank 1, bank 2 and bank 3. Each register bank will have 8 8-bit register which is ranging from R0 to R7. So in place of RN, we can use any register which is ranging from this R0 to R7, means we can use R0, R1, R2, R3 and so on, R7. So let's suppose take the example, suppose R1 is used along with this instruction. So whenever the microcontroller execute this instruction SUB BA, R1, it will subtract the content of R1 from the content of accumulator along with the borrow or the carry flag, and the result of operation is stored back into the accumulator. So this is the meaning of this SUB A, RN instruction. Next instruction is SUB B A, direct. So here with this instruction, the direct address of the memory where the data is present is specified with this instruction. So this addressing, this instruction belongs to the direct addressing mode, because the direct address of memory is specified with the instruction. So here 10H is nothing but the direct address of the memory where the data is present. So here at location 10H, suppose the data is present, suppose it is 1AH, which is the data present at memory location 10H. So whenever the microcontroller execute this instruction SUB BA, 10H, it will subtract the content of this memory location whose address 10H is directly specified with the instruction. The content is 1AH, the content of memory location is 1AH, and this content is subtracted from the content of accumulator along with the borrow flag, and the result of operation is stored back into the accumulator. So this is the meaning of this SUB A 1 SUB BA, 10H. Next is SUB BA, @RI. So here this ampersand, this @ sign will indicate that this addressing, this instruction will belong to the register indirect addressing mode, and in place of RI, it is required to remember always we use two register, that is R0 or R1 of any selected bank. So suppose in this instruction, I am taking the example, register R0 is used to indirectly hold the address of the memory location. That's why the addressing mode is register indirect addressing mode. So whenever this instruction SUB BA, @R0 is executed by the microcontroller, it will subtract the content of the memory location whose address is indirectly given by register R0 of any selected bank from the content of accumulator along with the borrow flag, and the result of operation is stored back into the accumulator register. Next is SUB BA, @data. So here this pound sign will indicate that the instruction belongs to the immediate addressing mode. So in this immediate addressing mode, suppose the data which is specified, 8 bit data which is specified with the instruction is 40H. So 40H is the 8 bit data which is specified with this instruction. So whenever the microcontroller execute this instruction SUB BA, 40H, #40H, so the content, that is 40H, which is the immediate data, is subtracted from the content of accumulator along with the borrow flag, and the result of operation is stored back into the accumulator register. So this is the meaning of this SUB A, #40H. Next arithmetic instruction is INC byte. So the operation performed here, this byte is incremented by 1. So and the incremented result will store into the destination. So here this instruction will increment the indicated variable by 1 if the byte value is FFH, and if it is incremented, then the result will be overflow to 00H. So if the byte is FFH and if we perform the increment operation or if we execute this instruction INC byte, so the instruction will increment this FF by 1, so the result will be 00 and there will be overflow occurs. So overflow flag will set to 1 to indicate that the overflow takes place, but the result will be 00. So it supports 3 addressing mode, that is register direct and register indirect addressing mode. So this increment instruction will support 3 addressing mode. The first is register direct and the indirect addressing mode. So this is required to remember. So for the increment byte, we use instruction INC. Let's see the format of this instruction INC. So this instruction again belongs to the arithmetic group of instruction. So the format or the syntax of this instruction is INC RN. Again, in place of RN, we can use any register which is ranging from R0 to R7. 7 of any selected register bank. So remember that in my previous class I had explained that how to select the register bank. So in 8051 microcontroller we have this 8 bit program status word register, and with the help of this program status word register we can able to select the register bank, and once the register bank is selected then only we can able to use the register of those selected register bank. So the very important point is here, if you want to use bank 1, bank 2, bank 3 and the register of the corresponding bank, so it is essential that we need to select the register bank with the help of the PSW.3 and PSW.4 bit of the 8051 microcontroller. That is, actually in 8051 microcontroller we have 8 bit program status word register. So here in this instruction, that is INC RN, in place of RN we can use R0 to R7 register, which is 8 bit register of any selected bank, whether it is the register belongs to bank 0, bank 1, bank 2 or bank 3. One more point which is required to remember, if you are not selecting any register bank, by default microcontroller will take the bank, the register of bank 0. So by default bank 0 is selected and the register of the bank 0 can be used. So here this instruction will increment the content of the specified register. So here, for example, the register is R5, and if the value of R5 is 04H, and if we use instruction INC R5, so the content of R5 becomes 05. So see here, before the execution the content is 04 and after the execution the content becomes 05H. So the content of register, specified registers, incremented by 1. So this is the job performed by the INC instruction. Next example is INC direct. So here the direct address of the memory which is specified with the instruction. So here 10H is nothing but the direct address which is specified. That's why this instruction belongs to direct addressing mode. So if I'm talking about INC 10H, if the instruction INC 10H. So this 10H is nothing but the direct address of the memory where the data is present. So whenever this instruction is executed by microcontroller, this instruction will increment the content of the memory whose address is directly specified with the instruction by 1. Next is the INC at the rate RI. So here in this instruction, this at the rate RI will, at the rate sign will indicate that the instruction which belongs to register in direct addressing mode, and here in place of RI we can use only two register, that is R0 and R1 of any selected bank. This is always required to remember, because the R0 and R1 register is only the allowed register of any selected register bank. So whenever this instruction is executed, if I'm talking about this instruction INC at the rate R0, so the content of R0 is used to hold the memory address indirectly, and when this instruction is executed by microcontroller it will increment the content of memory location by 1. The address of the memory location is indirectly given by the R0 register. So this is the purpose of INC at the rate RI instruction. Next is INC DPTR. So in 8051 microcontroller we know that DPTR is a 16 bit register. So whenever this instruction is executed by the microcontroller, the content of DPTR is incremented by 1. The addressing mode, that is register addressing mode, because the content is in the DPTR register, so DPTR register will hold the 16 bit value. This instruction will increment the content of data pointer by 1. A 16 bit increment is performed, an overflow of the low order byte of the data pointer, that is DPL is nothing but the low order data pointer register, from 0FFH to 00H will be incremented the high order byte, that is DPH. So here this data pointer register is divided into two 8 bit register, that is DPL and DPH. The DPTR is the only 16 bit register that is incremented. Example, let the content of DPH is equals to 12H and the content of DPL is equals to FFH. The instruction INC DPTR will cause DPL, that is 13H, and DPL is equals to 00H. So here the content of DPH is incremented by, So after the incrementation of this DPL, FF is incremented by 1, so it becomes 0 and the carry is added into the DPH. So here the value of DPH becomes 13 instead of 12. So this is the meaning of DPTR, increment DPTR instruction. Next is the DEC instruction, decrement the byte. So this instruction will decrement the byte by 1. This instruction will decrement the indicated variable by 1 and original value of 00h will be underflow. So it is decremented by 1. So the result will be FFH. So three operant addressing modes are allowed, that is register direct and register indirect addressing mode. So the instruction will decrement the content of the specified byte by 1. So this is the meaning of this DEC instruction. So following are the example of DEC instruction. The first is DECRN. Again, the register RN, which is used as a source register. So here the content of this register is decremented by 1. So this instruction belongs to register addressing mode. For example, in place of RN, the R5 register is used, and before the execution of this instruction, suppose R5 is equals to 06H, and if we use instruction that is DEC RN or R5, so here after the execution, the content of R5 is equals to 05H. So this is the meaning of this DEC R5 instruction. Next is the DEC direct. So here in place of direct, the direct address of the memory location is specified with the instruction. That's why the instruction belongs to direct addressing mode. And when this instruction is executed by microcontroller, the content of the specified, the memory location whose address is specified with the instruction is decremented by 1. Next is DEC at the rate RI. So here this at the rate sign indicate that this instruction belongs to register indirect addressing mode, and here in place of RI, R0 register is used to indirectly hold the address of the memory location. So whenever this instruction is executed by microcontroller, the content of memory location is decremented by 1. The address of the memory location is indirectly given by the register R0. Next is MULAB. So this instruction will perform the multiplication operation. So here the operation is A into B. The multiplication operation takes place. This instruction multiplies an 8-bit unsigned integer in the accumulator and the specified register. The low order bytes of the 16-bit product is left in the accumulator and the high order byte is in B register. So low order byte is in A register and high order in B register, addressing mode, that is register addressing mode. Example, let A is equals to 50H and B is equals to A0H. After the execution of MULAB, the content of register B becomes 32H and the register A becomes 00H. As 50H is multiplied by A0, the result will be 3200H. So here the high order byte in B register and low order byte in A register. So this is the MULAB instruction. Next is DIBAB instruction. So here the operation performed that A is divided by B. So B will hold the remainder and the quotient will be in A register. So this instruction divide the unsigned number in accumulator with the unsigned number in the register B. The accumulator contained the quotient and the result, quotient of the result, and the register B contained the remainder of the result. The content of A and B when division by 0 is attempted are undefined addressing mode, that is a register addressing mode. Let A is equals to FB and B register will have 12. Then we use instruction DIVAB, it will result A is equals to 0DH and B is equals to 11H. So this is the meaning of DIVAB instruction. So whenever the instruction is executed, it is required to remember this B register will hold the remainder and A register will hold the quotient of the result. So this is the meaning of DIVAB instruction. Next is DA instruction. So the DA instruction is used after the add or of adds the instruction. So here whenever the arithmetic addition operation is performed, so DA instruction is used for decimal adjust operation. So when the DA instruction is executed, the microcontroller will add 0110 in the binary or 6H in the lower nibble of 4 bits of the lower nibble of 4 bits in is greater than 9, or if auxiliary carry is set to 1 to correct the BCD problem. So whenever we perform the BCD addition operation, and if the lower nibble, that is D0 to D3 of the result is greater than 9, it means that it is invalid BCD number. Then we use DA instruction, that is decimal adjust accumulator instruction. So whenever this instruction is executed by microcontroller, it will add 06 to the lower nibble and the result will be the valid BCD number. And it will add 0110 in the binary of 6H in the upper nibble of 4 bit. If the upper nibble of 4 bit is greater than 9, or if auxiliary carry flag is set to 1 or AC is equal to 1 to correct the BCD problem. So whenever the upper nibble is greater than the number 9, so it is again an invalid BCD. So here, after the execution of this DA instruction, it will add the 0110 to the upper nibble, so the result will be the valid BCD number. The only use of auxiliary carry flag bit is when BCD addition and the correction is occur. If the BCD operation will have the invalid BCD number after the execution of BCD addition, then we use this decimal adjust accumulator instruction. So this is all about the arithmetic instruction. So in this arithmetic instruction, we have discussed the addition operation, decrement operation, then the multiplication operation, division operation, increment operation, decrement operation, and the decimal adjust accumulator operation.